The British and Irish Lions touring group from 1968 returned to South Africa recently, and Masicorp invited them to Masiphumelele in Cape Town to showcase their community project at Ukhanyo Primary School.
One of the things when we were invited was that we should be involved in coming in the community, not just come for a party for a week, and we're being wonderfully well looked after, but we wanted to come and see work in the community on a number of projects, and coming here today has been a wonderful eye-opener. There are dedicated people here who are trying to improve the lives of young people, and for me, very emotional actually, because a tremendous amount of hard work's being done by volunteers, and the future of this country is here. And so whatever little thing we can do to help and go away as well, and maybe support, make some support to this particular area.
I think it's vitally important for us because this is the new South Africa and this is what it's all about. There is no doubt, you know, it makes us feel a little humble because we can all see they haven't got the best of facilities, as indeed we've been looking around at some of the facilities that these young kids who are so eager and so determined to sort of succeed in the sport and play it, and yet the facilities are not as good as they could be or possibly should be. You know, they should have a lot more encouragement and a lot more money poured into their system so that they can play and be prepared like everybody else.
I think it's important for them to see after 50 years, you know, what's happening in South Africa. And I think it's important that they do have this sort of interest and not just go to Newlands and, you know, the waterfront. And that shows commitment that they want to give something back as well. I'm just once again enthused and motivated by somebody like Vincent de Bile. He's just such a powerful character, and I know there are many people involved in this project, but certainly on the sporting side, just to feel his passion for this project is just unbelievable, and to see what he's already achieved and what Masicorp has achieved. And again, he's come into a structured environment, which is incredible that he can use his power and his energy and his sporting connections to actually make a difference to these kids. And I've been to Masi, Laureus has projects with Cool Play here, so I understand a little bit about it, but just to feel again and to understand that 40,000 people have one primary school. Now, let's forget about the sports fields. Let's start there. You know, they need another four primary schools with sports fields and et cetera, et cetera. But there's got to be a start, and this is an admirable start. Just what Vincent and his team achieved here, well done to you. And he will succeed to make these kids, give them a better chance through sport.
I think today has been absolutely fantastic. I really take my hat off to the 1968 British Lions, who have come out as their 50th reunion and have been dedicated to not only coming out and watching games all around the country and socializing and having fun, but making a real concerted effort to get involved in projects like the Masi project, where they've been looking at how they can feed into the system, what they can give back and how they can contribute. So the project now is really in its first or second year now of development. The cricket nets have gone up, as you've seen. That was phase one. The teachers are becoming coaches, which is phase two. And the rugby field and the training facilities, which is the most important of all the facilities, is phase three. And that's what we're currently trying to raise money for. It's a three-phase project, the first being a large amount that we're trying to raise for the actual fields. But most importantly, we're just trying to get the community involved, the Nurtuk community involved, and the people of Nurtuk involved in simply donating a monthly amount, which equates to 1,200 rand per year, and that's going to be sustainable to keep us going from salaries and coaches' fees to the sustainability of the actual grounds. So it's a big project, it's a long-term project, but the fact that it's going to change so many lives in the Masi community and bring sports into a community which is impoverished is why I'm prepared to do everything in my power to help.
If the new field happens, it will mean a lot for the school, for the community, and for the kids as well. So it'll be great for us to have that playing field on the school, so we can practice, So we can practice tackling when we do rugby. We can practice fielding when we do cricket. And most importantly, we can invite the community as well to come and watch our games and invite high school kids to come and train us. So I think it's not only about the Ukhanyo kids. It's about the kids that are go to high school. It's about the community as well. I think it will benefit everybody.
From last year, there's lots and lots of changes because for more than 10 years I've been doing all the job alone, doing physical education, facing more than 50 kids in each class alone for, more than eight classes a day. But now there's a huge change because teachers are involved. There are more coaches from the community. I'm working hand in hand with Cool Play, which is the program that is doing life skills through sports. Even in our sessions, 60% of our time we do life skills, then 40% sports, because it's useless to just train the kid to do sports, but if the kid is not good up here, then there is nothing to do. So it's better to do life skills first, then you follow with a sporting code.